An interesting view on love in the Harry Potter world is how it differs with each person and each relationship. Bellatrix Lestrange and Hermione Granger, I believe, offer the perfect example of this different view.
Happiness can be found, even in the darkest of times, when only remembers to turn on the light.
The two witches both have love interests, but they are so far away from each other when it comes to expressing how they really feel. And that's because they both represent love, but they represent it at its best, its worst, and its scariest. Bellatrix's love interest is obviously Lord Voldemort, and Hermione's is Ron Weasley. Both women really do feel love, but it's quite alarming at how differently both of them come across when it comes to expressing it. Bellatrix is a married woman, but it's heavily speculated this was nothing short of an effort to keep face, as her surname was originally Black, and as many of you know, the House of Black demands complete loyalty and dedication to its beliefs. Well, it demanded, as in past tense, because the male line is extinct, so there won't be any demanding from the House of Black these days. Anyway, back to Bellatrix. She never loved Rodolphus, nor did she have any true feelings for him. Their association was through their dedication to the Dark Lord only. And Hermione, on the other hand, did have a brief romance with Victor Krum, even going as far as sharing a kiss with him when her feelings for Ron were really starting to grow. He was just a stand-in romance, however, and even though Bellatrix was married, Rodolphus was just a stand-in for her also. And I find it quite fitting that both women had sort of make-do men in their lives. They do, however, share the common aspect of love, but this aspect differs greatly on both sides. Bellatrix Lestrange was fascinated with everything Voldemort represented. She adored him and his ideology, as he stood for everything that she had been brought up to support and favour, except Voldemort took it further. He wanted to make a change in his eyes. I believe this suited Bellatrix perfectly. It's as if she needed something to dedicate herself to. She needed a purpose. She developed an obsessiveness over the Dark Lord, and ultimately fell in love with him. Her loyalty intensified by her passion. Her every effort was in the hope of pleasing him, while being terrified to be a recipient of his wrath. Loving someone that you're afraid of is vastly unhealthy, especially as they have not returned the feeling. The cursed child does not count. Which means that her obsession only continues to grow. It's what made Bellatrix so dangerous. While the other Death Eaters' crimes were committed in the name of Lord Voldemort, Bellatrix's vicious cycle of commitment came from her love for him. When we look at Hermione's love for Ron, it really does completely differ from how Bellatrix feels about Voldemort, but it doesn't start out entirely great either. Hermione's feelings develop over time. She doesn't realise she really likes Ron until it completely hits her in the face at the Yule Ball. That is just my opinion of when I identified Hermione's feelings for Ron developed. Other people have identified it earlier, but that's when I feel she really felt that her feelings were becoming strong for Ron. Now, Ron is terrible at lying. The fact that he thinks he's confidently shielding his feelings for her just goes to show how cocky he can be sometimes. The thing is, Hermione is well aware of how Ron truly feels. She's a clever, intelligent girl, but while she's confident in things like her academic and magical ability, she lacks the confidence to tell Ron how she truly feels. So it's a case of two people who like each other, but neither will take the first step. When the two eventually do get together, it's years of bottled feelings finally released, culminating into a beautiful, strong, long-term relationship, resulting in marriage and children. So this is just one example of how love differs in the Harry Potter universe, and more so how it's used to motivate and fuel the characteristics of each person involved. That is all for today's video, everyone. Thank you very much for watching, and I'm sorry it's been 2 days since my last upload. I was just really working hard on this video, and I wanted to deliver more of a quality video rather than just producing content for the sake of it. Make sure to follow me on Instagram and Twitter, and if I've earned your subscription, then hit that subscribe button. Thanks again.